4. Boop. 5. Boop. And 6. Hello, everybody, and welcome to the head placing ceremony. Woohoo! Yes, I have brought it back. I brought it back to celebrate 800 subscribers. I reached the 800 subscriber mark. Obviously, I'm a little bit late. We are up to 806 now. It took me a lot longer to build this than I thought it would, and I'm not even done building it. I don't have the other set of stands set up yet. Yeah, I'm going to have to figure out an easy way to get this duplicated over there. Hopefully without the heads. Because that would be kind of a problem, wouldn't it? Well, I don't have the heads to duplicate anyways. Alright, so this is the second time, quite literally, that I'm recording this episode, because the first time I tried to record this episode, my PC died. Well, was dying. I explained this in the last vloggy thing video. Basically, the motherboard is having hard drive controller issues and USB issues and this, that, and the other thing issues, and basically, I can't record on that PC anymore, so I'm borrowing my dad's big, honkin', beefy PC, and yeah, so I'm recording that. Let's put all my stuff back, put you away. I have a new sword. It's called Give Me Head, because, well, I needed something to get heads, like, you can guess why. It does 44 damage. I crap you not. That took that does more damage than I thought it did. All right. So today in the last episode we created a bunch of sieves. However they're pronounced. Still don't know how to pronounce them. That we put a cobblestone, gravel, sand, and dust into to get a whole bunch of shit out of it. I have obviously moved that, because it used to be right here, now it ain't. I have moved that into the mill to make it an actual frickin' mill. Yeah, this was initially designed purely as decoration, and it just kind of ended up being this way, and it works out really well. I got a solar panel up there that powers this entire system. Well, mostly anyways. And of course, I have my all of the stuff where I'm sieving dust, sand, and then the gravel. Whee! Boop! And, boink, this chest right here is the output that I left run for a couple hours. Not long. Probably like maybe 6 hours. And it's completely full. And I mean completely full. So we're going to have to think of some way to deal with that, because that's a considerable amount of stuff that I have to put away. Well, I could make a whole shit ton of chests. I could do a bunch of things. Like, I found these barrels, these item barrels, and I kind of went apeshit with them. Item barrels, boop, are basically barrels that you store one thing in, and you can store 128 stacks of things in each barrel. It says how much is in each barrel, but I have the spruce wood plank covers covering up the the numbers right there. Bink. Do I have it? Yeah, I do have other examples, and I kind of wanted to hide this. Ooh. Slime. I got to do something about that up there. I got to get rid of it. Well, I don't want to get rid of it. That's a really good source for hearts, for yellow hearts. Anyways. In here, I've turned into a somewhat storage room. So I've got stone, cobblestone, dirt, gravel, sand, dust. These are auto-filling. This is auto-filling up to the point where the sand fills up. And yeah. The auto wool thing, the auto shearing thing that I created several episodes ago, all the wool goes up here. So, like I said, I've kind of gone apeshit with the black wool's getting sheared. Why am I only have 29 stacks when I have 89 stacks of pink? Yeah, I don't understand it. Anyways, it's way the hell more wool than I could ever possibly need. Yeah, so all the wool goes up into here now, so I don't have to worry about that anymore. I have plenty of wool. I can do pretty much whatever the hell I want, which is kind of the goal for this, is to get to creative mode and do whatever the hell I want. So, I could make a whole shit ton of barrels for each and every item, and then worry about them filling up to 128 stacks and jamming up the system. I don't want to do that, because as you can see, you get a shit ton of iron. So powdered iron, crushed iron, and then broken iron, you get a shit ton of it. So it would basically fill everything, basically, and everything else would jam, and I wouldn't get any of the stuff that I get less of, like the silver ore or the platinum. So we got to do something about that. And I did show in the last episode that the aluminum, the powdered, the crushed, and the broken ore combined into blocks that you can put in the smelter and cook into two bars. For example, these blocks. Yeah, I told you I did this, I did this episode already. This is what came of that episode. So let's see if we can do that again. So what do you need to do all of this stuff? Well, we are going to process all of this stuff into its block form. And lots of things can be processed into their block form. The powdered, broken, crushed, as I mentioned. The skystone. I don't think the skystone can it? No. It's just used for whatever this page is. I don't know what the hell this page means. Let's see. Sirius quartz dust does what now? And throw it in a Richmond chamber and turn it into quartz crystals. All right, but basically, no. But the quartz crystal, I believe, turns into blocks, right? Yes, they turn it into Sirius quartz blocks. And unlike the nether quartz, come on, there we go. It can turn back from blocks. So that's the important part. Yeah, if we're gonna turn them into blocks for storage sake, we got to make sure we can turn them not into blocks anymore. Same with lapis, we can do that. Bone meal, we can't. Gunpowder, we can't. But flint, we can. We could turn flint into blocks of flint. Yeah, block of flint, which can be unturned into blocks of flint. Glowstone can turn into glowstone blocks, but I try not to. Redstone, we know we can. Emeralds, diamonds, coal, we know we can. So we could take the vast majority of this stuff so far and turn it into just blocks so they're easier to store. Let's take a nap real quick. Oop, maybe not. So what do you need to do that? Well, you need a couple of items. Boink. You need boom, liquid crafters. I love these things. Basically, they're automatic crafting tables, but they require a redstone signal. So you need timers. Boink. Don't need power. That's also power. We need item ducts to put things into it. I need a shit ton of filters to filter what goes into it. I need a bunch of hoppers to pull stuff out of the liquid crafters. I need chests to put the stuff that came out of the liquid crafters into. What else do I need? I don't think I need anything else in this chest, but this chest is here just in case I do need it. And apparently it is now nap time. And I also got an email, so I'm going to jump cut. All right, I'm back. That was for another project that I was taking care of. All right, so the liquid crafters. Let's get started on this thing. What do we need to do this? Well, let's start one little bit at a time. So let's start with these powdered ores. So we have tin, tin, silver, platinum, osmium, nickel, lead, iron, lots of iron, gold, copper, aluminum, and that's it for the ores. And I did all that because I'm counting. So we need 10 liquicrafters just to take care of the powdered ore. So let's do that. Boop, boop. We're going to start at the bottom because, well, that's how we have to do things. Let's see, output goes here. Yeah, right about here. So output goes here. It turns this way. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11 for a chest, and then 10 hoppers. 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right. So that gets us 10 hoppers. Then we put 10 liquicrafters on top of said hoppers. There we go. And then item ducks into the liquid crafters. Boop. All right, now before we connect this to the system and get stuff pumping in there, obviously we're going to want to filter what goes in there. We only want, say, iron, powdered iron ore to go into this liquid crafter and powdered lead ore to go into this one. We have to do one at a time, because the liquid crafters can only do one at a time. So I have a bunch of filters that I can throw in there. And these will work. They're not exactly fast. You can only filter three things. We, of course, want to set this to a whitelist. But if we, or since we're only filtering one thing, that's not going to be a problem. And I don't think, yeah, the filters don't limit how many things can go in at once. So if I can output one stack, this will input one stack. Boop. All right, set that stuff aside for a moment. And then we'll grab one of each of the powdered ore. So tin, silver, platinum, osmium, nickel, lead, iron, gold, copper, and I just fucked everything up. Okay, so I just fucked everything. Anyways, that was copper, and aluminum was the last thing. Yeah, I pushed a button, I grabbed a stack of something, and everything just kind of went bonkers because there's a whole shit ton of stuff left over in the sieves that can't get into the chest, but once I move something out, then it could get in the chests, and yeah, oh well. Oh well, not the biggest thing, not the biggest problem in the world. So, we will, also should do this one at a time so I can keep track of exactly what I'm doing. So, filter tin into here, and then 4 tin will equal 1 tin ore dust. Bloop. Then silver. 4 silver. And so on and so forth. And there we have it. All the liquid crafters are set up and ready to go with 4 powdered ore. And I just threw the spare in the liquid crafter. Basically, this is the inventory of the liquid crafter. And there's even liquid inventory, so you could put fluids and such in there. So if a recipe needs a bucket of water, per se, you can pump water directly into the liquid crafter, and it will use the water instead of a bucket, which is kind of cool. But I don't need to worry about that. Let's use this one as an example. So I have 32 in here, so this thing's ready to go. Obviously, it's not doing anything right now. I can just pull... Oh, wait. No, I can't. Oh, I thought I could. Huh. Okay, I think that's a new thing. I think the liquid crafters used to be able to pull things out. As long as there was enough in the inventory, you could pull them out. But I guess that's not a thing. At least not a thing anymore. But the liquid crafters do not need power. However, they do need a redstone signal, which I didn't grab any redstone, did I? Boink. Well, conveniently, there's plenty of redstone hanging about. And the redstone can go directly on the liquid crafters. I didn't know this, honestly. I didn't know that they could go directly on the liquid crafters. And I need another type of block. Let's say cobblestone. Boop. Because I have a buttload of cobblestone and it replenishes itself. Put a block of cobblestone there. And then we can put our timer on here. And I use the RF tools timer because it seems more, less... It seems to break less than the Project Red timer. Or the blue timer that I don't remember what it was. Blue power. Yeah, that's it. Boop. All right. So by default, the timer is set to like one tick delay, which is pretty much a constant redstone signal. I don't want that. I want it to fire approximately every second. I could probably kick it up a bit. Probably, if I was worried about delay, I think the server is powerful enough to process that. So right now it's set to fire off a redstone pulse every 1 second. Boop. And you can see that this liquid crafter is now empty. It doesn't have its powdered ore dust or powdered ore anymore in it. And that's because the redstone signal fired off, it outputted a copper ore dust, and then got sucked out with the hopper, and then went into the chest. All of them will do this. Boop. So all we have to do from this point is connect the item ducts up. Boop. Right? Yes, right there. Boop, boop, boop. And then we need a servo, which I have a powerful servo. Boop. That's a filter. Resonant servo. Now, you can use just regular servos and such. I use resonant servos because they output 64 at a time, up to 64 at a time. They can output lower. And they output it really, really fast. So it's like really, really quick. So I ignore it. And then we can watch it just start sucking out these powders. Oh, and everything's turning back on. And it's making noise. Boop. So everything's getting shoved in here. Yeah, there it goes. There's some iron going out at it. And you can see it processing. It's outputting and then getting sucked into the hopper and then getting shoved down into the chest. Gold's doing its thing. There were two stacks of gold in there? But as these sieves output more stuff, which I don't think we're going to see because it's going to cram itself full of the crushed and the broken and then everything else, like the sand and the dust. So that's pretty much all that this system's going to do at the moment because we're out of space in our giant chest. Well, we can fix that by adding two more rows of pretty much exactly this thing for the crushed ore and the broken ore. And there we have it. Basically, it is the same exact setup as here with the flashing redstone on top of a liquid crafter set up to create the ore with a filter set to whitelist with the ore from the pipes, from the chest, so on and so forth. Repeated. Hi, Kelly. Again and again. So we have the... crushed and the broken all up here ready to go. I haven't connected the pipe yet because I wanted to put that on camera. So this is what we got right now in the chest. So a whole bunch of stuff. And then boop. And then we get to watch it start doing its thing. Because now it's sucking out all the broken and the crushed and everything. So I kind of almost wished I used the transparent item ducts, but the opaque item ducts are cheaper to make. But see, as you can see, it's actually pulling in stuff from the sieves in there into the chest, and it's pulling out of the chest pretty damn fast. It's also filling the chest pretty damn fast with stuff that doesn't go into the liquid crafters. Well, we will work on that next. But I'm just waiting for this thing to finish doing its thing. Come on. There it goes. That's about as close as done that it's going to get for right now. All right, so we got liquid crafters doing their thing. We've got gravel ore coming out. We've got... Ooh, I didn't break these. Pop and pop. We've got sand coming out. Of course, we've got dust coming out. I think I could do something really creative with the different colors of sand, dust, and gravel here. I'm going to have to think about it. I mean, I'm going to have an assload of it, so I should be able to do something interesting with it. I haven't decided yet. But yeah, that gets us those three, anyways. And it gets us some free space in our chest. We do have a lot of stuff. So from here, what I'm going to do is do exactly what I did with the ores, but do it with the things that we can put into blocks and pull out of blocks. So the coal, the redstone, emeralds, diamonds, flint, the quartz crystals. See, you could do this with amber, but there's not a lot of amber. We can do this with quicksilver. But let's not do that right now. Let's count up what we have to work with. Ooh, I can put the bone meal back. Let's see. So we have coal. So let's put some coal in there. Diamond, emerald, redstone, glowstone. Oh, wait. No, not glowstone. Put that back. Go away. Flint, lapis, quartz crystal. So I could do it with those things. That makes 7. Right? Just those 7? I think that's just 7. I could do it with amber and I could do it with quicksilver. Well, let's do that. 8, 9. Do we have a 10th? See, these are sands, ancient spores, exotic seeds. For the record, if you're on a server like us, where there's basically no such thing as a jungle biome, I have searched up, down, left, right. There is no such thing as a jungle biome on this server. There's an assload of mushroom biomes. I'm actually starting to think that there's a glitch and that the mushroom biomes have been replaced, or the mushroom biomes have replaced the jungle biomes in this game. I really do. Ooh, we actually have so much crap that it's spilling out the sides there. Interesting. I'm gonna have to fix that. Let's just turn this system off for right now. Off, off, and off. So the pulverizer will stop making things. The sieve will take a little while to wind down. I have no idea what's spitting out. I don't know what's spitting out. I am very confused here. I have no idea why that stuff's spitting out. Because this is the stuff that's coming out the sieves. But the sieves aren't... I don't get it. I don't get it. I don't understand. I'll figure it out later. Some other time. Boop, boop, boop. Alright, but let's work on this. So we have... 9 items. So we have 9 chests to play with. Let's see, where can I put this that'll be relatively easy to deal with? Let's say right here. So we'll bring the pipe out here, start it here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 chest. Oh shit, I have 8 hoppers. 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, let's go quickly make another hopper. What else? I have 8 filters. I need another filter. Shit. I have 10 liquid crafters, so I have plenty of that. I have a timer, so I'm good there. Copper, I'm going to need redstone, but I can get redstone. I have a resonant filter, I could use that. What else do I need? I need a hopper, so I need a chest. You know what? I'm just gonna find all these parts and come back. Boop. All right, so that makes 9. I had a spare filter, which is good. Boop. Which you might have actually seen when I opened that one chest. Which I totally didn't see. And then, of course, the filters. Boop, boop, boop. No, boop. And then from here, it's a simple task. Whitelist. Put the quicksilver in. 4, right? No? Ah. So you need 9 quicksilver to make... Or 9 quicksilver drops to make a single quicksilver. All right, that's not a biggie. But from here, I mean, it's pretty much straightforward. You put in what you need. Yeah. Set whitelist, set the filter, and then put in... See, okay, the amber only needs 4. But diamond, for example, needs 9. The quartz crystal needs 4. The coal, however, needs 9. And so on and so forth. And then all we have to do is connect the pipage. And now we got it exporting coal and shit that it's importing. As long as it can export faster than it can import, you'll be good. Which is probably a good reason why you want a resident servo, because it's just significantly faster when it comes to outputting stuff. Boop. Alrighty, and then from here, we only have a couple more things to deal with. Are you done? Hey, you're done. Boink. What do we have output-wise? Block of coal, block of diamond, block of emerald, redstone, flint, and lapis. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6? I should be getting 9, shouldn't I? Why am I not getting 9? Emerald, redstone, flint, lapis, coal, quartz. It's doing its thing. Amber. Should all be ending. Wait. Quartz, amber, diamond, quicksilver. So, wait, I'm now confused. Oh, no, there's everything else. Okay. It just didn't make it down to the chest yet. I was very confused there for a second. Alrighty, so that freed up a little over half of our chest, which is cool. Of course, we're still going to have a problem with the sand and the dust and everything else that are just basically going to fill this chest. But we can deal with that with... barrels, and we're going to have to because we can't do anything with bone meal, for example. If we look at what it makes white things. And I don't think there's any kind of storage block design for bone meal. No, not really. Sand? Does sand turn into compressed sand? Is there such a thing? Because there's compressed dirt, compressed cobblestone, and I believe compressed gravel. There we go. Compressed sand. So we could make compressed sand. And dust. I think dust is pretty much useless, actually. Yeah, dust kind of does nothing. It's really designed for the sieve, and that's it. It could be used for a building material, but that's really it. So from here, all I have to do is just basically filter everything into barrels, whoop, which I have some of set up over here. So blaze powder, glowstone, skystone, certus, quartz, bone meal, and gunpowder, which I think is most everything. And I have a pipe over here somewhere. Boop. Yeah, there, right there. That pipe right there. The original idea was that it was going to connect directly to the system, and I don't think I'm going to do that. At least not right off the bat. I'm going to have to figure out exactly how I want these to connect. So I don't think I'm going to right now. I think I'm just going to leave it as is for right now. Because, as I did with the mill, where I took everything from over there and put it in the mill, I think I'm going to take this wall of stuff and put it somewhere else nice and pretty. Probably underground, probably not in a building. Yeah. So I'm probably going to hide all this stuff, make it look nice and pretty. And then I will connect it to the storage barn. But on the next episode, I am going to set up a system to deal with this stuff. So we have all of these ores to deal with, and all but one of them go into the furnace here, the forge here. So I could manually put everything into the smeltery here, but, you know, that kind of defeats the purpose of making everything automated to begin with. So, next episode, gonna cover how to basically deal with what we have here and turn it into something really useful. And by really useful, I mean really useful. So, I will see you guys in the next episode. And as always, keep playing the game and have fun. Bloop. I wonder if I can sleep.